When bringing the archive value to our report, we saw that a timestamp needs to be specified and the archived value will be retrieved for that timestamp. However, there may or may not be a value archived at that specified timestamp. So, how does PyDataLink decide what data is retrieved? To answer this question, let's have a look at this graph. It shows the raw archived values for the internal temperature of mixing tank 1. We can see a data value here and here and here and so on. And if we interpolate between these points, we can see what was going on in our process at any particular time. So let's say we want to see the values of the internal temperature at 9 a.m. today. What exactly is going to be returned by PyDataLink? And the answer is, it depends. It depends on what retrieval mode we choose. The default mode is auto. It interpolates the value at the exact timestamp provided, unless the points store discrete values such as digital state points or step points. And how is the behavior different for step points? PyDataLink will always return the previous point instead of interpolating and retrieving the value, which could not be appropriate for a step function. The interpolated retrieval mode always interpolates the value at the exact timestamp provided, again, unless we have step points. If a compress event doesn't exist at the exact timestamp and you use the previous or next modes, the previous or next compress event from the timestamp will be retrieved. For the previous only and next only, the difference is that PyDataLink will ignore any event at the exact timestamp specified and will always retrieve the previous or next archived value. And the last mode, the exact time, retrieves the value if and only if an archived value exists at that exact timestamp, down to the second. It returns no events found if no value exists at that timestamp. Alright, it's time to practice. Your manager needs a report they can open each afternoon to see the current values of KPIs for mixing tank 2. Your manager also needs to see the KPI's values at midnight today. She also wants to be able to type in a timestamp and see if there is an archive value at that exact time. We already have a template prepared for this exercise. It is the activity report sheet in the PyDataLink exercises file. So let's open it first. Now let's bring the AF attributes to our report. Click on cell A8 and go to search. Navigate to OSI SoftPlan database and then select the mixing tank 2 to bring its attributes. You can hold the Ctrl key on your keyboard and select all four attributes in one go. So let's select external temperature, internal temperature, level and flow rate. Make sure the data item length is set to full path. And now click on OK. Now select the current value function. Select the four attributes as your data items. As you can see, it is possible to select multiple data items at the same time, so let's do it to save up some time. Select time at left and click OK. Now we want to see the KPI's values at midnight today. Although it is not specified in the exercise, let's use the archive function and bring up the values from midnight today using the interpolated previous and next retrieval modes. So first, let's copy and paste the attribute names. Now click on cell B19, select the archive value function, now select the attributes as our data items. Remember that we can select all of them in a single step. Select cell D14 as timestamp, retrieval mode interpolated, and time at left option for the timestamp. We will repeat it twice, but now choosing the previous and next retrieval modes. And here I want to show you a trick. Keep the configuration wizard open and just modify the output cell as well as the retrieval mode from interpolated to previous instead of doing everything from scratch. Always make sure you select the correct output cell to not overwrite any of your existing data. Okay, now let's do the same for the next retrieval mode. The last step is to be able to type in a timestamp and see if there is data available at that exact time. So let's use the exact time mode for that. I will again use the existing function and only modify the output cell as well as the retrieval mode. Now try typing in different timestamps and see how the function updates.